Hello, I'm State Representative Keith Downey, and I am here on behalf of 40 state legislators from all across the state, from every walk of life, and I am proud, we are proud, to nominate your next U.S. Senator from the state of Minnesota, Kurt Bills. Right now, everyone in this room is represented in the United States Senate by Amy Klobuchar and Al Franken. And they're led by Harry Reid and Barack Obama. So are you tired of that?
Yeah.
And are you ready for some real hope and change?
Yeah.
Then Kurt Bills is your man. You know what? We have taken some serious economic broadsides in the last few years. Our society has been taking broadsides for decades, and our constitutional republic has been under attack from within for nearly a century. Are you tired of that?
Yeah.
Are you ready for some real hope and change?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Kurt Bills is your guy. If you're looking for somebody with broad enough shoulders to defend our conservative principles no matter what, Kurt Bills is your guy. If you're looking for somebody who cares enough and cares deeply enough about the middle class and the average Minnesotan that he will appeal to them just by virtue of who he is, Kurt Bills is your guy. If you're looking for somebody who can crush the opposition when it comes to the debate about the economy and our fiscal situation, Kurt Bills is your guy. If you're looking for somebody who will appeal to students and young people, not because they're a political category whose vote he's got to win, but because he cares deeply about them, Kurt Bills is your guy. Let me show you the headline. Minnesota GOP endorses public school teacher for U.S. Senate. Let's endorse Kurt Bills. Let's put him on the Econ 101 Liberty bus. Send him around Minnesota, straight to Washington, D.C., to start fixing the mess that's there. I am proud to endorse Kurt Bills for U.S. Senate.
Hi, my name is Kate Engstrom, and I've known Kurt Bills for about 4 years now. Kurt is the type of person who puts his whole heart into whatever he's doing. He'd come to our high school Young Republicans Club and challenge us with questions that we'd never considered before. And since becoming Concordia's College Republicans president, I've spent time at the Capitol advocating for change, and Kurt Bills was one of the very few representatives who critically engaged with what our group had to say. In fact, it was Kurt's class where I first grasped the true scope of our economic problems. Our current leadership understands very little about economics, which is why having Kurt Bills defeat Klobuchar this November is absolutely critical. It is therefore my great privilege to second the nomination for Kurt Bills as the U.S. Senator from Minnesota.
Good morning. I am Cindy Bills, Kurt's wife. Thank you so much for being part of this incredible process, and I want to thank so many of you for being hospitable to my family as we traveled around the state these last few months. Kurt's decision to run for the U.S. Senate was really difficult. I love our quiet, simple life, raising our family. I suppose those of you who know how full of children our house is with our home daycare know that quiet probably isn't the best description. But couldn't someone else do it? You know, we're kind of busy right now. But I thought about the leadership of this country and what we need, especially right now. We need someone with values, someone who young children can have as a role model, someone like this incredible teacher, coach, and father that I know, someone who Christianity is the core of who he is and whose faith is as exemplified in everything that he does, like the man who comes home late from a busy Saturday and still make sure his family gets up for church Sunday morning. We're always a little late, but we try. Someone whose life is a model of service. You think spring break is going to be a great opportunity for some downtime for a teacher. When Kurt sees a need, he's off roofing a house, fixing someone's plumbing, whatever needs to be done. We need integrity, a leader, someone who will stand up for freedom, stand up for what is right, even if he's standing alone. For those who know Kurt, I don't need to say any more. We need Kurt to be in Washington. There is simply no better person for this job. Thank you.
I'm Jason Lewis. You probably know me as America's Mr. Right, but long before that, I was Minnesota's Mr. Right, because I'm a Minnesota resident. And I'm glad to be here today to speak on behalf of Representative Kurt Bills. You know, Kurt's my kind of guy, and he's your kind of guy, too. When we're talking about the United States Senate and getting the debt and deficits under control, we need an economics teacher, and that's exactly what Kurt's been doing all these years. You know, there used to be a time when Amy Klobuchar said she cared about deficits, when they were in the $200 to $400 billion range. But now that we've run consecutive deficits under President Barack Obama at $1.4, $1.5 trillion, Amy Klobuchar is nowhere to be found. It's almost as if she likes these sorts of deficits, you know, Democratic deficits. We're at a tipping point in America. We simply cannot continue to spend and borrow the way we are. So we need somebody in Washington to make the tough decisions. We don't need a feel-good, self-appointed consumer czar like Amy Klobuchar, who tackles every issue but the tough ones. We need the tough decisions to cut the budget across the board, every agency, every department, without raising taxes and killing the economy. We're at a tipping point in America, and it calls for courageous leadership. Representative Kurt Bills is the guy. So join me in supporting Kurt Bills for the United States Senate. Vote today to endorse Representative Kurt Bills and help him take Economics 101 to Washington, D.C.
I've been teaching economics for 15 years, so you can imagine the questions that I've answered from my students as we go over our various deficits and debt. And in 2008, one of my students asked me, "Mr. Bills, what are we supposed to do about this?" And I realized that he was seeing the greatest deficit of all, a deficit of leadership. I'm Kurt Bills, small business owner and economics teacher, and I'd like you to get behind me and help me bring Econ 101 all the way to Washington. As your next U.S. Senator, I will focus on the spending, paring down our spending at the federal level to its constitutional provisions. Our monetary policy is morally corrupt. It steals purchasing power from working class families and from future generations. Obamacare has become an even greater infringement on our personal liberties and individual rights. Our opponents will try to control our lives and control our health care. We'll offer freedom of choice and free markets for lower prices and higher quality. Tax reform has been talked about for decades. It's time to go to Washington and reform the system, make it simpler and make it more efficient. I will bring my knowledge and experience to Washington to finally tame our tax code. As a public school teacher, I know that I need a vibrant private sector so that my classroom is funded. Right now, the federal government is so large that it's crowding out that private sector, and it's destroying the free market system. As your U.S. Senator, I will work to get the federal government out of the way of the people. I am pro-life and will always work to defend the unborn.
Kurt Bills is a guy who gets it. Not only is he teaching economics in the classroom, but he's living it day to day as a small business owner himself.
Well, all three candidates are conservative, but what sets Kurt Bills apart from me and the reason I think he would be the best choice for U.S. Senate is his background in economics. He's taught economics, he understands economics, and he understands that we can't tax ourselves into prosperity.
I think Kurt's going to be able to take that knowledge, that ability to bring his other peers in the Senate, really to give a vast understanding of what rural America is all about. And I think he'll make a great U.S. Senator because of that.
Well, I have a four-year-old son, and I really worry about what our state and our nation is going to look like here for the future.
He's going to have college education to pay for. He's going to have issues of getting a job. And I feel that Kurt Bills has the economic experience that we need to get our nation and our state back on track.
Well, Kurt, as a state representative, I think has gained a lot of credibility with mainstream Republicans and those of us who've been active for a long time. And then also because of his new and fresh ideas, he's brought a lot of people to the party with him that haven't been active before. And I think it's that unifying force that can drive us to victory in November.
This election is about the economy. This election is about jobs. This election is about the future solvency and economic security of our children and grandchildren. Government doesn't grow prosperity. The private sector grows prosperity. Government doesn't create jobs. The private sector creates jobs. And in order for this country to prosper once again, the level of government must be reduced in order for the private sector to grow.
Too many lawmakers in Washington are focused on their next election rather than on the solvency and posterity of our country. But a high school economics teacher whose focus is the future of our country, not his political career. A man who built roads in order to become an educator in economics. A man who looks into the faces of our posterity every day in his classroom. This is the man who can build bridges with his clear and true message of the basic logic of economics. Kurt Bills, with his stance on deficits, his stance on monetary policy, and his stance on the Constitution, is the man who can bring Econ 101 to Washington and move this country forward again.
Thank you so much. I've made my case that I'm the best candidate to represent and articulate our shared principles across the state of Minnesota. United, we will be strong. We will expose Amy Klobuchar's neglect to our current and future generations and restore the potential of the private sector by bringing Econ 101 to Washington. I need your vote. I need your vote, and I'm asking for your endorsement. As I've traveled around the state and in my conversations and emails to you, I frequently talk time and time again about facing our giants. As many of you know, the story, the origins of this analogy come from the first book of Samuel, where David faces and slays Goliath. The story sums up well the perceptions and the reality of our nation's problems and the perceptions of this race. Politically, the experts say that Amy Klobuchar is unbeatable. She's a nice person. And hey, have you tried her hot dish recipe? That's all well and good, but Minnesota isn't electing Miss Congeniality this November. Very good. We know what Amy's been doing the last 6 years, and we know what she's been regulating, trying to earn fawning headlines in the local newspapers. It's easy to have a senator guided by political virtue. We need to elect a senator guided by economic virtue. With the current crisis in Europe as an example, we will expose Amy Klobuchar's voting record, and her broad base of support that's an inch deep will subside to only a shallow pool of the most liberal progressives. Trust me, Amy is not the giant we are facing. The giants we are facing have been created and grown by Barack Obama, Harry Reid, Nancy Pelosi, and their rubber stamp, Amy Klobuchar.
These liberals have teamed up to give us years of trillion-dollar budget deficits. These are budget-busting amounts, just to prove that they need to raise taxes. And in their quest to do so, they'll bankrupt the country. The debt that Klobuchar and Obama have created are a giant we face. Entitlement reform is a giant that Amy doesn't want to face. And there are also giants that Amy has created. My wife and I have seen how much damage can be done in 6 years to our business and our family. Inflation undercuts the savings of our parents in retirement and destroys the purchasing power of our wages. High gas prices and increasing college costs stretch our already thin budget. Persistent unemployment and lack of confidence discourages our unemployed neighbors and hamstrings entrepreneurs. And uncertainty in the marketplace keeps capital on the sidelines. Finally, our tax code and regulatory environment overburden small and large businesses in constant compliance costs. These are all giants she has helped to grow. If nothing, her past performance shows us that the only thing we have to gain from reelecting her is more debt, more regulation, and more costs. For Amy and the Democrats, the giants are too big to defeat. I say they're too big to miss, and we need to run on them. David said, by making his stand against Goliath, that everyone would know that we won't be saved by sword or spear, but by our beliefs. And what are those beliefs? They are the same that our founders held. We are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights. We are equal in these rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. At the end of the French and Indian War, England began to tax its colonies to replenish its treasury. The colonists protested this second-class treatment of taxation without representation. They thought themselves as British subjects, equal under the law. When their protests were met by abuses and usurpations, they stood up. Merchants and farmers, shopkeepers and shipwrights stood up to the giant of the time, the British Empire. They pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor to bring forth a new nation, conceived in liberty, to secure the blessings of that liberty for their posterity. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's us. We are their posterity. We cannot afford to give up on their sacrifices. We cannot take their gift for granted. We must rededicate ourselves to restoring the republic they created and to securing the promise and potential of future generations. Just as David had five stones at the ready in his pouch, we have five principles to draw upon to face the giants of today. Economic freedom, the life lived liberated from debt and dependency and making our own choices. Without economic freedom, there is no political freedom. Incentives to work hard, produce, and be rewarded. Competition, because the idea that not everybody gets a trophy is a good thing. Voluntary exchange, a life free from mandated consumption like Obamacare. And lastly, private property constituted by the concept that your land is your land and yours to use how you see fit for need, want, church, or charity. With these principles, we can turn America around in the next 6 years. Reducing government debt, cutting government spending, and cutting the federal workforce will lead to private sector growth. Opening up America's abundant natural resources will reduce energy costs, and reducing excess regulation will spur job growth. And repealing Obamacare, reforming Medicare and Medicaid will lead to lower cost, higher quality health care. We believe in it. When faced with their giants, France and Greece have shown that they are headed back to the short-term comforts of socialism. But Americans will do better. We will face our giants with the five principled basics of free enterprise. And in the next 6 years, we won't see fear, uncertainty, and doubt in people's eyes. We'll see courage, certainty, and confidence as we give them back their freedom, personal responsibility, and liberty. That's the American dream. That's what lives on today in Minnesota. That's how we beat the Giants, and that's how we take our country back. You got it? You want to come to me?